going on, everybody? From Westfield Theatre Department, I'm Harry Schlatter, and you are watching Hot Ones. It's the show with hot questions and even hotter wings. And today, I'm joined by Colin Brown and Braeden Anderson. You may know Brown and Anderson from their roles as Mark and Joanne's father from Westfield High School's Rent, and as Stacee Jaxx and Hertz from our upcoming performance of Rock of Ages. So, are you guys ready for what we're about to do?
As ready as I'll ever be.
So, how are you guys with hot food?
I love it. You know, it's kind of a toxic relationship because I love hot foods, but it doesn't sit well with me.
Yeah, I like hot foods, and I always get like spicy things, but I have a little, you know.
First ring.
Close up.
Hold them into your mouth. Make sure you zoom in.
Yeah.
Cool down a lot.
Yeah.
Well, it's like lukewarm.
So, you both have a long history of theatrical performances, but for some of our younger audiences, why did you start theater?
I got into theater in sixth grade. I was at Deer Park Elementary School. And we were doing The Magical Land of Oz, you know, just renamed Wizard of Oz. It was the same plot. And I was the Scarecrow in that. And so, I mean, that was a big, like, my big break, you know, it was a big part for me. And I just loved being able to be something I'm not and entertain people and, you know, have it stop.
So my first time I ever, like, did theater was probably when I was in third grade. I was doing the summer camp of Yada, you know, that we put on here. And that's where I met actors like Colby Deslick and Kevin Clay and Trevor Knickerbocker. And they were all like super cool. And then I had the opportunity of being in Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat as the child's ensemble here. And so technically my first Westfield production was when I was 8.
Wow. And a Cappy show.
Right? They also won a Cappy.
Whoa! You basically won a Cappy.
Basically won a Cappy.
Yeah, basically. I mean, crossing our fingers for the next one.
Yeah, I just love it because, like, especially with theater, is it just gives you the opportunity to like live lives that you don't get to experience by ourselves. You know, like we live in very like limited human experience where we like go through our lives, and this is just like a way for me to do experiences that I like. Wouldn't have otherwise, even though it's fictitious, you know.
Next one.
Los Calientes.
I got
that's
yeah,
Spanish.
I got a lot of. Oh, has Colin not drank a single drop?
I'm not doing it until after.
Oh!
I have no reason not to. I mean, we've got
see about that.
We'll see how long it'll last. I'm trying. I'm gonna try.
So, I know, Braeden, you used to play trombone in the band until you started to pursue theater exclusively about sophomore year. Whereas Colin has sang in chorus for ever since elementary school, right?
You did your research.
Yeah. So what I want to know is, for Colin, how you think that extra training might have helped in performing for musicals like Rock of Ages, like Rent currently, and if, Braeden, you feel like you're behind or you feel like you've caught up, how do you feel about that?
Braeden first.
So I actually don't necessarily feel behind because it gave me a lot of experience with just like being able to read music and like follow notes and stuff, and I actually have really good relative hearing and stuff, but you know, it gave me all like the basics that I need to be able to like sight read music and like learn music and stuff. I do feel a little behind in the sense that like I didn't get, you know, vocal training until like last year and stuff, and to some extent I feel kind of behind from that. And I actually didn't full-time pursue theater until junior year. I was only able to do one show sophomore year, and that was just a play. That wasn't even a musical.
And cool.
So with doing choir, it kind of gave me a jumpstart with singing and stuff, and I was doing show choir back in the day, so I learned a little bit of dancing, you know?
Yeah.
Don't remember a whole lot of it anymore. Can't say that I'm really a dancer at all, but it just kind of taught me to, you know, get to the movements and remember choreography, so that definitely, I think it gave me a bit of a jumpstart and confidence of dancing and singing for musicals specifically.
Definitely need that confidence when you're on stage.
Yeah. The original hottest sauce in the universe.
So it's time for Explain That Gram, where we do a deep dive on our guest's Instagram and they explain what's going on.
Oh,
okay. So we got this picture. This is posted on Braeden's Instagram.
Oh, what?
God, I love how I liked it myself.
You liked your own post.
Okay,
shall we get those likes? What's going on in this picture?
So, many of you guys know Despicable Me.
Of course.
Really? What's that?
It's a show. Anyways, it has these people on it, you know, the minions. And there's this girl named Cammy, who I believe came in with these minion themed cupcakes. And I was like, wow, they're so cool. And they had, it was like, were made with Twinkies and stuff. I'm pretty sure one of those was yours, actually, Harry.
Oh, really?
Yeah. And so we had these cupcakes.
They're perhaps cool. Stone Middle School.
It was in Stone Middle School. I'm pretty sure it was 8th grade.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure, yeah.
Simpler times.
Simpler times.
All right, Colin, we'll do one from you now. Can you describe what's going on over here?
Oh gosh. Okay, so, first of all, that was end of 8th grade. Those were darker times for me. That was when I had my long, curly hair. And still wore glasses and had my braces and everything.
Oh,
that
yeah.
was after
classic middle schooler curse.
Yeah, that was after our 8th grade like farewell concert for show choir. And at that concert, it was you would audition to our choir teacher to have our own song and to be able to like perform a solo. So John Henry and I auditioned to do My Way by Frank Sinatra. That was like a duet for it. And we ended up doing it at the concert, and it went really well. And it was, we had actually dedicated it to his uncle, who had died a little bit prior to it. And it was a really nice thing that we had done. And so the whole, like, caption was a dumb play on words. We all did it our way, like, me in 8th grade trying to be clever, you know, trying to be quirky.
Yeah.
But, you know, that, like you had exposed earlier, those were my show choir days. They put me ahead, apparently.
Yeah. So we should probably do the third thing.
Oh, really?
Oh, it is getting hotter. That's really good, though. That's warmer.
What's going on in this picture?
Okay. So, that is...
Me too.
That's actually Deathstroke that I drew during church. Because I was bored.
You okay with it?
All right. It was like my cheeks.
Yeah.
Or like
I just thought it looked cool, so I took a picture. And I was really, really bored, so I took some paper and I just drew Deathstroke. And that's actually been my lock screen for a really long time until I broke my phone in the pool because I'm stupid and I jumped in with it.
All right, Colin, what about this?
Oh, okay. Freshman year. Still a dark time. So that was at our President's Day. The George Mason Winter Classic duck meet. And if you won your heats at that meet, you were given an inflatable ducky. You know, put in a bathtub with you. And I, like, won 4 heats, you know, not trying to flex. And that was a picture with my friend Talia, who's on Riptide. Shout out to Talia. And
you're watching
shout out to Riptide. Yeah.
Shout out to Riptide.
And, you know, it was like, we all would win those ducks, and it was just, you know, taking a picture with all of them. We all had stupid names for them, like, Katie LeDucky. there were a bunch of, like, dumb, punny names that we had for them, though.
Brayden, the last one for you.
Okay, so, this was 7th grade. We were taking pictures, when we did Beauty and the Beast. That was when I was... Oh my god, I hurt so much. That was when I was Basically, that was just a picture from like the cast photo, and I just on myself, and you know, I really love that show. That was probably, aside from Joseph, that was really my first like real show that we put on. And Harry was Gaston, and I was Lumiere, and it was fun times.
Yeah, it was fun times.
Back when I was the OG Lumiere.
Shout out to Louis Stanvia.
Is that a picture of a picture? Because I think I'm seeing a reflection
of a picture.
Wow,
yes.
You really bootlegged it there.
Yeah.
Yeah, in it, great. It was
high quality photography.
Oh, yeah.
And it was a
I'll
really
think about
bad
the best.
Camera.
Photography is your other passion, I assume?
No.
All right, and Colin, this is the last one.
Oh, good times right there. Okay, so that was at the Outer Banks. I think summer of 2015, 2016, with my grandpa and my cousin Michael. Shout out to Michael. And it was, we went on a fishing trip. I think I was asleep for a good chunk of it. But, you know, I'm wearing my trademark bucket hat. Love bucket hats. Oh, they shelter you on all angles. Like, you can think about it. It has an absolute ergonomic design. It's in the front, the sides, and the back. You're not getting burned with that baby on, okay?
No.
You don't need any sunscreen.
Wow,
you don't proper, like, completely protected.
You need it on your head.
It's a good way to go about things. Oh, sorry. So, yeah, I mean, it was just, you know, good times with my family. I love fishing, and I love my family. And I love the Outer Banks.
So, you're going strong over there. Yeah.
I don't know if that one was hard
already.
Shout out
already. To Colin's girlfriend, Alyssa.
That one was hard
keep
already.
It in,
no,
keep
do
it
not
strong.
Shout her out. She doesn't deserve it.
I would have the program.
For making me suffer like this.
No, she's just making me suffer.
All right.
For the next episode.
So, despite not interacting much on stage, Hertz and Stacee, to some people, are similar because of their extremely strong drive to get what they want. Has there ever been a time where you felt there was nothing that could stop you from getting in the way of reaching your goal?
When I was 12, I was made patrol leader of my scout troop, and we have this one scout leader. He was my advisor. He was my friend's dad, and he just really inspired me. You know, we ran a troop that was boy led and adult advised, and he really just inspired me that like if you put your mind into something and you like try your hardest, like you can really do anything. Like just. I just felt really inspired, and he kind of inspired me and the other guys to go camping every single month and go on hikes every month. It was fun.
That's awesome. And yeah, you just never stopped leading. Yeah, that's a. I mean, it looks good in college. It's
good. I mean, I got my Eagles coming. So.
There you go. Highest award you can get, right there in the Boy Scout. Colin, is there anything you
just want to say first? So that's one of my ears. What was the question?
Yeah,
again?
Some people feel that. It's like ears, sinuses sometimes.
Yeah. What was the question again?
So, has there ever been something or a time where you felt like there was nothing that could stop you from reaching your goals?
Going into this year, I picked up a vocal coach, shout out to Amanda Fish. And I just felt like I didn't want anything to stop me into progressing as myself and being who I wanted to be as an actor. And improving as one, and just bettering myself in my craft. And I didn't want anything to stop me from getting the roles that I wanted or getting the shows that I wanted. It didn't matter the roles, but you good there, Braeden? Didn't matter.
Okay.
Mattered the shows.
I was like,
feeling like my ears. But it mattered the shows, you know.
You still haven't touched your eyes. Just want to point out.
I just want to be a part of the show.
Braeden thought he would touch his eyes.
Yeah. I just want to be a part of the shows, and I just want to be a part of the cast, and be a part of. This department and the family that I love. I didn't want anything stopping me from that.
Yeah, that's awesome. Yeah. Look at us, we're all major roles and
doing great.
Musical we're about to do.
In our best, living our best life.
Living our best life. Here we go.
My mouth is like pulsing.
Oh. Yeah, it's literally just starting to fade and now we're doing the last.
So guys, this last sauce is called the last dab.
Oh, I know the shtick, yeah.
And we call it the last dab because it's tradition around here to put a little extra on the last wing.
Yep. Like one does. Yep.
Like one does. Here we go, we got the little... Takes a little... Not too much, just a little.
I'm finishing this wing.
I just want to point out, Alyssa, if you're watching...
Oh, she'll be watching.
Colin has not touched that milk.
I have not.
Brandon and I, weaklings. But this man over here...
I've been doing nothing but grabbing
it. Oh man, you're going hard.
Just a little. Don't have to torture yourself.
Oh, I want to.
I've been doing that the whole time.
And you guys have consistently cleared off your wings. Not many people can say that. I just want to point out.
I've been eating this.
Alright.
Oh. Okay. Last one.
Are we ready?
No. I can't even feel it anymore. That's going down fast. It's done. Back right your nose. Oh my god. I can't hear anything right now.
You don't want to blow your nose, or else you'll just bring everything from down there.
Sure.
Alright,
I'll just. What? I think I can do this. That actually hurt more.
I think I agree with you.
Really? I'm not so sure.
No, I'm just getting used to it now. Like, I think I might be numb.
So what we're saying is we're gonna go get more wings, and we're gonna get more last
night. Yeah, I'm gonna break some in a second.
That's it. You guys cleared those pretty well. Like, really well.
Oh, the whole thing.
Great job, guys. Wow. I gotta really put more last dab on that.
Oh, yeah. All right, let's do this question.
All right. No, that's it. You made it, guys. Make sure to come out and support us. Make sure to come out and support Westfield High School Theater Department.
Rock of Ages.
Oh, no, Rock of Ages. Show dates are April 26th, 27th, 28th, and May
4th and 5th.
4th and 5th.
Woo!
Gonna get our last
shot.
Yeah.
That's it.
Anything? There is usually
a... on three. Or no, spicy on three.
Okay. One, two, three.
Spicy.
Oh, dang it. This guy.